Hello and welcome to Midday.com. I'm Anjali Singh, and today with me I have the veteran actor Ms. Ratna Pathak Shah. Ratna ma'am, welcome to Midday.com.
Thank you.
And you know, also when we were in the lockdown, we had our own ways to cope up with whatever time we had, or you know, tough, difficult, depressing, whatever you may call. What were the things that ma'am you were doing, and Chardul also I want to know from you, both of you, how did you kind of spend your time during the lockdown?
I did a lot of bartan jhadu pocha, which everyone did, and cooking and all that, which was fun for a while, but after a point it just became a chore. We tried to do a certain number of things online, doing storytelling for children, doing poetry recitation, etc., which was also fun, but I deeply missed the experience of being in a rehearsal with other actors. And I also found it terribly disconcerting to act looking into a camera that I'm operating myself and seeing myself in front of me. I'm constantly being, distracted by the way I'm doing something, the way my face worked, or you know, that's not my job. To look at me is not my job. That's the camera person's job. I was very, very delighted to be in a situation where I didn't have to look at myself while I'm acting. So this film was a great relief to get out of all the boredom and the constrictions that we had been operating under.
Chardul, how about you? Anything interesting that you did throughout this lockdown?
A lot of interesting things. I didn't know how many columns my floor had in tiles. I know them now. By count.
That's so wonderful. That's so productive.
Yeah. Earlier, I used to hear all kinds of filmmakers talk about how washing dishes is a meditative thing for filmmakers and things like that. So I did that, you know, was meditative in the first month. And so I was at home with my mother and my cousin brother. So it was there were interesting conversations between me and my brother dividing chores. So,
ma'am, I don't know if you know about it or if you saw it or no, but then one interesting thing that happened was Doordarshan was telecasting a lot of old, sitcoms and all that. And I happened to watch Idhar Udhar. And I was telling you, I don't know, did you see that during the lockdown or no?
No, I wish I'd known. I didn't know that. I
watched
to watch Idhar Udhar.
Episode 1 to the last episode, and I was like, when it got over, because earlier it was not such long seasons and all, I was so elated. It was such a stress buster. Tell me something about that time, you know, some nostalgic, anything that you remember, you know, it was so simply shot, so simply conveyed, yet it was so entertaining.
Idhar Udhar was very special for me. It saved me from becoming a terrible bore as an actor because it introduced me to comedy. I was, of course, prepared to be one heavy dramatic actress type, as everyone is when they get out of drama school or film school or wherever we get our training. But I didn't get any work at all except for Idhar Udhar, which was a comedy. And thank God for it. And thank God for Lilliput and Anand Mahindru and Supriya and Ravi Baswani. We had such a wonderful time. I mean, can you imagine? That was in 1984. We made a serial about two people, two women and a man living together without any sexual or familial connections. And that was perfectly fine. Nobody objected to the fact that hamare desh ki sanskriti bilkul tabah ho rahi hai iski wajah se, or anything of that sort. I thought that was fantastic. So Idhar Udhar was great fun. It taught me a lot of things about myself. It taught me, most important, that drama school had given me very few skills that were of use when I was actually working on a job. So I had to redevelop my skills. It also taught me to be humble and to be able to accept the fact. And working with Supriya was absolutely delightful. My mother was also in it. So it just became like a family scene after a point.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.